Good morning, BBHHS. Today's Wednesday, April 19th of 2017. I'm Jonathan Qualls, and now let's get over to this morning's news and announcements. For any 9th, 10th, or 11th grade girls who may be interested in auditioning for the 2017-2018 BBHHS flag line, there will be an informational meeting on Monday, April the 24th at 2:30 p.m. in the band room. Attention seniors! Are you heading off to college this fall? If so, plan to attend the College Survival Skills Seminar being held at the Cuyahoga Valley Career Center today, April 19th, from 6:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. At this event, you will hear students from a dean of students, a college professor, a financial advisor, a university police officer, and current college students. Learn how to make your transition to college a successful one. Go to cvccworks.edu to register or visit the guidance office and pick up a flyer. What would you like to say about your high school experiences, your reflections, your reminiscences, or your vision for the future? Here's your chance to address your classmates, teachers, and families at graduation. One or two seniors will have an opportunity to try to deliver speeches at commencement on May 27th at the State Theater. You should submit a speech of about 6 to 8 minutes in length. Speeches must be typed and double-spaced. The speeches are due in the main office by 3 o'clock on Friday, April the 21st. Names are removed before the speeches are submitted to a committee of teachers and administrators for judging. The selected speakers will then be announced as soon as possible in order to begin rewrites and rehearsals. We hope many of you will consider submitting speeches. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Gonter in the main office or Mr. Mueller. Thank you for your participation. If you like baseball, and more importantly, inexpensive baseball entertainment, the baseball team is selling tickets to the Cleveland Indians Double A team, the Akron Rubber Ducks. Yes, that's a real thing. The Akron Rubber Ducks game is on April 23rd. The Rubber Ducks are hosting the Altona Curve. First pitch is set for 2 o'clock. The tickets are only $4. If you have never seen a minor league baseball game, it's a great experience and a great opportunity to see the future stars of the Cleveland Indians. Tickets are on sale in the athletic office, or you can see Mr. Much in room 166. If paying by check, please make the check out to B's Athletics. And that's all for today's news and announcements. We hope you enjoyed them very much. I'm your main man, Jonathan Qualls. And don't forget, today's Earth Day. And also don't forget, get better every day.
You know, parents are the same no matter time, no place. They don't understand that us kids are going to make some mistakes. So to you other kids all across the land, there's no need to argue. Parents just don't understand. But one year, my mom took me school shopping. It was me, my brother, my pop, and my little sister all hopped in the car. We headed downtown to the Gallery Mall. My mom started bugging with the clothes she chose. I didn't say nothing at first, I just turned to my nose. She said, "What's wrong? This shirt costs $20. I said, "Mom, the shirt is plaid with a butterfly collar." The next half hour was the same old thing. My mother buying me clothes from 1963, and then she lost her mind and did the ultimate. I asked her for Adidas and she bought me Zips. I said, "Mom, what are you doing? You ruined my rep." She said, "You're only 16, you don't have a rep yet." I said, "Mom, let's put these clothes back, please." She said, "No, you go to school to learn, not for a fashion show." I said, "This isn't shining, not come on, Mom, I'm not Bowser. Mom, please put back the bell-bottom Brady Bunch trousers. But if you don't want to, I can live with that, but you gotta put back the double-knit reversible slacks." She wasn't with it, everything stayed the same. Inevitably, the first day of school came. I thought I could get over. I tried to play sick, but my mom said, "No, no way, forget it." There was nothing I could do. I tried to relax. I got dressed up in those ancient artifacts. And when I walked into school, it was just as I thought. The kids were cracking up, laughing at the clothes mom bought. And those who weren't laughing still had a ball, because they were pointing and whispering as I walked down the hall. I got home and told my mom how my day went. She said, "If they were laughing, you don't need them, because they're not good friends." For the next 6 hours, I tried to explain to my mom that I was going to have to go through this about 200 more times. So to you other kids all across the land, there's no need to argue. Parents just don't understand. Okay, here's the situation.
went away on a week's vacation, and they left the keys to the brand new Porsche. Will they mind? Well, of course not. I'll just take it for a little spin and maybe show it off to a couple of friends. I'll just cruise it around the neighborhood. Well, maybe I should. Yeah, of course I should. Pay attention, here's the thick of the plot. I pulled up to the corner at the end of my block, and that's when I saw this beautiful girly girl walking. I picked up my car phone to perpetrate like I was talking. You should have seen this girl's bodily dimensions. I honked my horn just to get her attention. She said, was that for me? I said, yeah. She said, why? I said, come on and take a ride with a hell of a guy. She said, how do I know you're not sick? You could be some deranged lunatic. I said, come on, Tux, my name is the Prince. Besides, would a lunatic have a Porsche like this? She agreed and we were on our way. She was looking very good, so was I, must say. Word. We hit McDonald's, pulled into the drive. We ordered two Big Macs and two large fries and Cokes. She kicked her shoes off onto the floor. She said, drive fast, speed turns me on. She put her hand on my knee, I put my foot on the gas. We almost got whiplash, I took off so fast. The sunroof was open, the music was high, and this girl's hand was steadily moving up my thigh. She had opened up three buttons on her shirt so far. I guess that's why I didn't notice that police car. We're doing 90 in my mom's new Porsche, and to make this long story short, when the cop pulled me over, I was scared as hell. I said, I don't have a license, but I drive very well, officer. I almost had a heart attack that day. Come to find out the girl was a 12-year-old runaway. I was arrested, the car was impounded. There was no way for me to avoid being grounded. My parents had to come off of vacation.